Many Christians look at the culture today, and what we see are that things that were once considered wrong are now considered right, and things that were once considered right are considered wrong. And so we kind of see it all in moral terms, that there's been a moral slide. And certainly there has been, there's no question about that. But that's not as deep as the crisis goes. Below the moral question, there's the identity question. And not only have we had a moral slide, we've had what we might call an anthropological shift. Now, that's a big polysyllabic way of saying we no longer agree on what it means to be human. Now, you look at the great creeds of the church, the Apostles' Creed, the Nicene Creed. It doesn't even mention what it means to be human, because that wasn't an issue that was up for debate. You look at our founding documents in America, we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all are created equal, endowed by their Creator. This was a common assumption that framed out this American project. What we're trying to do now is the American project without that agreed upon what it means to be human. I mean, I have three daughters. From the very beginning of their lives, they have been told that the most important thing about them is what they look like. Kids born today are told that more significant than being made in the image of God is their sexual inclinations and desires. So we're taking something that's just part of our humanity, our sexuality, our sexual preferences or whatever, and we're saying that this is the most important thing about us. And then we're taking the most important thing about us, right, that we're made in the image of God, the only thing throughout history that's ever grounded dignity and value, and we're saying that it's a matter of personal moral preference. We've had a significant shift in identity in our culture, and I tell you what, our teenagers feel it more than anybody.